Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the beautiful world of Cookie Crew. Are you serious?
Bro, how'd I die?
This was the one intro. I was trying so hard not to die. I was just running around like a normal person. Let's go! We got a sponsor! Arcosaur Games reached out again to let me know that Dragon Raja is receiving a massive update. Wait, you guys haven't heard of Dragon Raja? One of the best, if not the best, MMORPG mobile games out there? Seriously, what are you guys doing? I honestly don't play too many games on my phone, but this one has me hooked. The graphics alone are so sick, and I honestly cannot believe it works on my phone. The world is huge, and you can explore pretty much all of it. The best part about this game is that you can basically create an entire new life for yourself. You can choose whoever and whatever you want to do. Dragon Raja also has one of the best storylines I've ever seen on a mobile game. The decisions you make in the game actually affect the storyline later on. There's a vast career system where you can pretty much choose any profession, ranging from a chef, a singer, or just a simple shopkeeper. You can even buy a house and decorate it with so many different customizations. Personally, I chose to build myself a giant castle. You know, who wouldn't want to have a giant castle? I also completely forgot to mention that you get to pick out your very own class. There's a soul dancer, a sneaky assassin, a powerful blade master, a puppeteer, a reaper, an idol, and a gunslinger. I chose the assassin class because I like to be sneaky, especially when eating my cookies. It also has some of the most high-tech weapons I've ever seen in a game. And the best part is, they're getting a massive update soon. This update includes a new shopkeeper career, a fighter class, a new house system, and also a battle royale game mode that you can play with your friends. I play this game pretty much anytime I'm on my phone, which is pretty much almost like all the time. Some people might say I'm slightly addicted, but you guys should definitely join me on Dragon Raja. You can click the top link in the description down below to get the game. Thanks again to Dragon Raja for supporting today's episode. Let's get back to it. Oh, by the way, if you guys missed out on the last episode, we did a lot of pretty cool things. The main thing is this. We got a brand new dragon called a Dragon Fruit Drake, which is still a very tiny baby. I asked you guys for some name suggestions for my brand new wolf and also my Dragon Fruit Drake in the last episode. Dricolus H wanted the wolf to be named Scout, and Ko Kaya wanted the Dragon Fruit Drake to be named Apple Slicer. Come on, little buddy, we got ourselves a name. Scout for the wolfie, and Apple Slicer for the dragon. Here you go, Scout. Welcome to the Beckbro Army. And Apple Slicer. This is so cool. I guess for now, I can leave Apple Slicer over here while he's still growing. But ladies and gentlemen, in today's episode, I am going to be upgrading one of my dragons. I honestly haven't really done anything like this so far. But you guys might remember in the earlier episodes, I managed to trick my friends Adam and Alec into helping me tame this. Probably the strongest dragon in the entire world of dragons. Now, if you haven't seen a tidal wave, the butterfly leviathan dragon before, you're probably a little bit confused. This is technically speaking a water dragon. But I saw you guys comment, and a lot of you guys were telling me that if I right click with the staff, access the inventory, and right in this middle spot, if I put a conduit, I can actually upgrade this dragon. Now, surprisingly enough, I didn't really know what a conduit is, but from what I've read, it's basically like a portable beacon. It'll give me special effects underwater, and it will also damage any mobs around the conduit. The issue is that in order to craft one, I need Nautilus shells and the Heart of the Sea, which are some of the rarest items. So today, it is going to be mine and Tidal Wave's quest to head out into an ocean and get those items in order to craft the conduit. Before I go, I need to grab some food for Tidal Wave. Wait a second, oh my gosh! What? Apple Slicer just grew up! Well, that was super unexpected, but let's go! Now it actually fits the name of being like an apple-looking fruit. But let's see if Amity has any extra fishies. She has leather, a tripwire, a tin can. We also, I guess, have a goldfish. Lots of salmon and cod. This is going to be useful. This is the most savage rat in the entire world of Cookie Craft, and I love her. All right, Tidal Wave, we got the fishies. We are ready. All we have to do is find an ocean. The Nautilus shells supposedly can be fished, but Amity has had no luck there. Another way to get your hands on one is to kill drowned mobs that are holding them. So I think that could probably be the best way. The Heart of the Sea is going to be a tad bit more difficult. In order to get that, I need to find buried treasure, which will give me, I believe, some sort of map in order to find my way to other treasure that might have the Heart of the Sea. We're gonna have to figure it out as we go, ladies and gentlemen. This is entirely new to me. Tidal wave is so slow, dude. Really close to the water, though. We'll be there in about 3 hours. While we're waddling along, if you guys have not liked today's video, you gotta do it right now, or tidal wave will tidal wave your cookies. They'll get all soggy, and it's not a tidal wave of milk, it's a tidal wave of water. Also, if this is the first video that you're seeing by me, and you want to subscribe because you're interested, you gotta do that as well. I'm trying to make this one of the biggest and best series on all of YouTube, and I need your guys' help to do that. But we're officially in the water. This is where tidal wave shines. Tidal wave is basically like an overgrown dolphin with four ginormous dragon wings. Pretty sure I can also go low and then jump out of the water. Yup, that is so epic. I don't know if I'll find anything useful here. I don't think this ocean gets very deep. I also just realized too, I can't breathe that long underwater. Something attacking me? Oh my gosh, oh flip, dude, I forgot there's piranhas in these waters. So it started turning nighttime and I decided that, I didn't wanna be in the middle of an ocean at night, so we're gonna go to sleep. And I also remembered too that I forgot a very important item. As you can see in one of these chests, yes, okay, I have a turtle shell helmet, which if I'm not mistaken, will give me extra water breathing. Might be able to travel to different waypoints as well. Let's see, one of these has to be an ocean, right? Okay, this one seems, okay. I think this might be close to an ocean. Let's go test it out. Okay, here we go. I'm underwater and okay, sweet. I have an extra 10 seconds of water breathing. It looks like there might be a ruin right here. So I need to find some sort of buried treasure map. Oh, we have another silver glider over there. I want to catch it so bad. I'm gonna have to wait. All right, let's go see if there's any chests. It might be useful to bring one of these magma blocks with me because I'm pretty sure they create extra bubbles. Okay, so far there was nothing down there. I didn't think that there would be. What we need to find is an underwater treasure in some sort of abandoned boat. Okay, I think I finally found a massive ocean. Let's use our silver glider to just fly all the way down. Okay, this should be a good spot. No, Aiden, come back. I don't want you accidentally getting eaten by a ginormous sea serpent out here. All right, tidal wave, we're in for an adventure. Whoa, I think I found an underwater ravine. I have to be careful not to stay underwater too long though. Whoa, there's another one! And I'm trapped down here, this is bad! Tidal wave, get us out of here ASAP. Oh my gosh, that was so close. No, do not go back underwater. Do not go back underwater. Just keep jumping. Keep jumping like a dolphin. Piranhas. No. Stay in the water where you belong, you flipping fish. Yes, tidal wave is eating them. Oh my gosh, there's another butterfly leviathan. I'm actually going to see if I can maybe lure it onto land and possibly tame it. Okay, tidal wave, you go back in your crystal. This could get ugly. Oh, snap. Okay, I've lured it onto land. Let's see if I can get it to go down in this hole. The plan may have failed slightly. This thing did not want to play nice, and it started biting me a lot. I think this might be a shipwreck right here. This is where I can find the buried treasure map. First things first, I need to get all these piranhas out of the water. I'm also running out of cooked food, so I think it's in my best interest to make a furnace. There's a little camp over here, so I feel like this is a good spot to spend the night. I'm also going to make a bed because I completely forgot about that. I'm starting to hear a lot of creepy noises. That I don't like. Okay, we're gonna place down the bed. Can I go to sleep? Okay, I think we're all right. No. Get concussion and you're dead. Okay, I have some more food, so I should be able to go check out that sunken ship. We also have what appears to be some sort of dungeon down here. It's entirely flooded, so I feel like it's not the best. Oh my gosh. There are so many skeletons here. I could probably use this in order to get tons of bones. Wait, am I trapped down here? Oh gosh. Tidal wave, do the thing where you fly out of here. Okay, I managed to build my way out of there. Now to find the sunken ship. Okay, it's right in front of me. There's also a ruined portal down here. Let's check out the abandoned ship. There was nothing near the ruined portal. Oh my gosh, okay, we have a chest. Let's see, we have lots of paper, cool looking leggings, some chance cubes, but unfortunately I have no buried treasure map. I think I saw another buried treasure map down here. Okay, yeah, I see another chest. I just don't know if I can get in. Okay, there we go. We actually have a lot of useful materials in here, but still no buried treasure map. And that is my cue to get out of here. Come on, tidal wave. We have bigger and better things to do. I'm going down one more time just to make sure I got everything. Oh my gosh, there's more chance cubes and the buried treasure map. This is huge. Okay, let's get rid of this shield. I think that's really all that I needed. Let's see exactly what this thing says. So, I think I'm in the bottom right corner and the X is directly to my left. All right, so we're on the map. The buried treasure will be right over here. We're getting close. Warmer. I think it's right in this little sand pit. It's really difficult to tell if we're on top of it or not. I tried digging down right in front of us, but didn't see anything. It seems like it's in this direction just a little bit. Let's go see if it's down maybe under one of these blocks. I could really use a shovel. Oh my gosh, wait, there's also a drown nearby. These are the things that are probably gonna have the Nautilus shells. Since I don't have a shovel, it's probably my best interest just to start like digging around. It says it's a couple blocks this way. I'm pretty sure the buried treasure spawns one block under either like gravel or sand somewhere on the buried treasure map. And it says right now we're basically right on top of it. Yes! Finally, I actually found it! Okay, I need to grab some air. I literally cannot see anything. I'm so lucky that I found that. Okay, now I can open it. We have a lot more chance cubes. We could do an entire episode where we open them. Tons of iron. We have emeralds. Gold as well. We have lots of cad. And most importantly, we got the heart of the sea. As you guys can see, once we surround it with Nautilus shells, we can make the conduit. Then, Tidal Wave will be upgraded. Okay, how do I get out of here? Directly up we go. And it's nighttime. Of course. Okay, we made it back. I'm going to go to sleep, and then our next objective is the Nautilus shells. Whoa, what the? Did a crab just, it just pinched me. Where you at, crab? Get over here, crabby. I'm gonna pinch you back, boy. Give me a Nautilus shell? I got potatoes. What about you? You got a Nautilus shell? Not at all. I guess while we're out here, it couldn't hurt to just open one chance cube. Let's do it.
Okay, no, that was the worst idea ever.
Oh my gosh, what did I do? Okay, I'm leaving, I'm going home. Great, we have dragons. I cannot wait until Tidal Wave is upgraded so I can just stomp on everything around me. Let's go check on Amity. I know that it's really rare to fish a Nautilus shell out of any sort of body of water, but you know, maybe. She's pretty lucky. Oh my gosh, she actually got one! That's sweet. Now I believe we only need 7 more. We also got a lockbox. What is this? I just got a compass out of nowhere. What the? Yo, there's a mod that lets me teleport using a compass? What the? Okay. Well, I could just teleport down into caves. Okay, a compass is now super valuable to me. Look at this. Boom. I just teleported. Wait, I went through my house. This is a little bit strange. I think the best way to get a Nautilus shell, or at least a lot of them, is from a wandering trader. So I'm going to see if I can find any of those. There actually used to be a wandering trader that would be around my house all the time. It was so long ago though, I kind of forget. What did I do with it? I thought I trapped it somewhere, but I can't remember exactly where. Oh, wait a second! Okay, I think I remember where it was. First things first, let's go grab all the emeralds that I managed to collect. I think it should be a lot. From that alone, I got 14. A lot of the chests around too have a ton. Oh my gosh, I actually have so many. I was carrying around a cup with me, but we might need a lot. So I remember the wandering trader was around my house all the time, and it was just so annoying. It would come in. I think I put it over here. I just forget where I buried it. See, look, the llamas are here. Wait, I heard it. Hold on. Is it? Oh, it's right down here. Wait, oh my, wait. Why is he invisible? He's disguising himself. What? But he still does have the trades. And it has a Nautilus shell. No way. The rest of the trades are kind of trash, but I'm very glad that I trapped this guy. Okay, so we only need 7. What? You ran out? We were so close too. I need 2 more. I guess I'll leave you trapped down there. You were so close to being free. Okay, so I just slept. I forget if the wandering traders are able to restock. He also might just despawn. I'm pretty sure after a while they kind of just leave. So I got super lucky that this guy wasn't too old. Okay, crap, dude. He does not restock. We got a problem. I could buy some sea pickles. So that's kind of cool. The only thing left for me to do is either go fight drowned mobs or just hope that Amity found some more while fishing. Let's see. We have 2 more Nautilus shells. Dude, there is no way. Amity, you are the best rat ever. I don't even know how do you do it? She's just a straight savage. All right, well, we have officially done it, ladies and gentlemen. It was a ton of work, honestly. If you guys stayed until this long in the episode, go comment down below #cookies. But this is it, the moment of truth. We have the Nautilus shells, we have the heart of the sea, and we now have a conduit. That means we can officially upgrade Tidal Wave. Okay, so if I right click, access the inventory, put the conduit in the center. Dude, oh my gosh, she was just glowing. Look at the conduit. Oh my gosh, it's floating right above the head. Wait a second, can I now summon lightning in? It summoned in lightning when I first did it, which was really, really, really sick. Let's go over to the water to test it out. Okay, so the conduit's definitely there. Whoa, there's just particle effects all around us. So it's basically like a portable conduit. Look at that, yeah, we get conduit power. I think that means that I can breathe underwater indefinitely now, which is going to be super useful. Whoa! Okay, all right. I can now also summon in lightning. All I have to do is just aim at a mob. Let's test it up there. Looks like we have a sheep.
Yo. That is so overpowered. It's not even fair.
Even these mobs in front of me, I should be able to just electrocute.
Yo! This is so sick!
And also, every mob around me gets damaged just from being around the conduit. Even underwater, they get electrocuted. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think we have officially upgraded Tidal Wave into a flipping tsunami. I hope you guys did enjoy today's episode of Cookie Craft. If you did, leave a like, hit that subscribe button, and also turn on all notifications if you haven't already. That is gonna wrap it up. I hope you guys did enjoy. My name is Beck Bro Dragon Master Jack, and I will see you guys all back again here very soon for a brand new video. Peace out, dudes.